two land-based empires dominated Asia in the 1500s, Mughal India and Ming China. Descendants of Timur overran the Delhi Sultanate and formed the Mughal or Mongolian Empire. The greatest emperor was Akbar. Although illiterate, he used the ruling principles of the ancient Persian empires of making accommodations with the local populations. While the Muslims had control, the vast majority of the population were Hindus, over 100 million. First, Akbar married a Hindu princess who eventually bore him three sons. Then he waived the taxes paid by Hindus to go on religious pilgrimage to temples and later taxes paid by non-Muslims. Therefore, he was tolerant to other religions. Akbar governed by creating an administration in 12 separate provinces. While the majority were Muslim, some governors were Hindu Maharajas. Most taxes were paid by Indian small farmers. If floods or famine affected the harvest, the administrators would give tax money to those affected by the tragedies, an early form of socialism. Again, you tax the rich, the government comes in and redistributes to the poor. Hindus also followed their local laws rather than Sharia. Many Muslims thought Akbar was too sympathetic, so Akbar had to put down some revolts. Again, this only encouraged Hindu cooperation. Akbar also chose the Persian language of Farsi for official documents, angering Muslims that thought it should be Arabic, the official language of Islam. By the end of his reign, revolts existed among his sons, and the cause of his death is unknown. His son Selim, later known as Jahangir, a Persian name because he married a Persian widow, he himself continued the policies of his father, and Indian riches grew as European countries began to import copious amounts of products from the subcontinent, a lot of different spices. His wife was very powerful in herself, a Persian. She had paid attention to major women's issues, such as donating land and dowries for orphan girls, and she also sponsored a lot of Persian art in the architecture in India. Also, Nur Jahan owned a fleet of ships that participated in a lot of this ongoing trade with Europeans. Jahangir's son, Shah Jahan, was the chief of military and would succeed his father. He is best known for building the Taj Mahal in Agra, India, but for his beloved wife that died at the age of 39 after bearing 14 children. Shah Jahan's building splendor needed the raising of taxes, causing revolts, and he was not as popular among the majority Hindus. This policy increased under his rule of his son, Aurangzeb, denying building permits for Hindu temples and doubling food taxes for non-Muslims. Revolts grew amongst the Hindus. Shivaji Bhonsle founded the Hindu Maratha, a nationalist movement that could not mobilize to defeat the Mughal armies. Instead, they began guerrilla warfare against small bands to weaken parts of the administration. Aurangzeb fought back viciously but became very unpopular, and by 1700, the French and British firepower increased, and they would now start to become active players on the Indian subcontinent. So while Akbar's reign was solid, the expenditures of his grandson in building the Taj Mahal and other projects would cause financial strains on the populace. Different civil wars would erupt, thus allowing the French and British to start to establish holds on the Indian subcontinent by the year 1700.